Hi, I'm John.
Hi, I'm Shinji.
Hello, I'm Yvonne, and we're the Smart Hamper.
The Smart Hamper is a laundry sorting system designed for separating laundry among family members or roommates in a shared living space.
The way the system works is that we have an IR sensor that gets triggered when you take a picture, and then the camera sends input to the Google Cloud API, which then creates a feature vector. The feature vector is composed of a label and RGB values. Then it gets sent to our server, which connects it to the SVM, and then
which classifies
the different clothing items, and returns it to the Raspberry Pi, which turns the motor to the right bin.
Ready to classify a shirt, we'll hold it up in front of the IR sensor, which will trigger the camera to take the picture. This picture is sent to the Google Vision API, which will come back with labels and metrics on colors present in the picture. These will be formatted into a feature vector of the format that you've all mentioned, which will be sent to our EC2 server, which is hosting our SVM. Let's see how it works. We'll hold the shirt in front of the sensor. The picture was taken. And when it comes back with the correct response, the shirt gets tipped into the correct hamper.
Mm-hmm. Over here, we can see some GET requests.
Let's try again with another shirt. We hold it up, trip the sensor, wait for the response from SVM, and sort into the correct bin. Try with the second garment. Trip the IR sensor, capture the picture, wait for it to get processed, and the laundry gets tipped into the correct hamper. Our server over here. These are the feature vectors along with the classification from the SVM. Our feature vector contains four dimensions, one for the label and three for the RGB values of the picture. The label is an integer that corresponds to the type of clothing. So we have three classes, one for shirts, one for pants, and one for text or shirts with graphics on them. And RGB values are ints from 0 to 255, and we construct a four-dimensional feature vector which goes into our support vector machine. The support vector machine plots the points in four-dimensional space and tries to come up with curves to separate them into classes. And this example has three classes, X's, triangles, and O's, that are separated by these curves. Our example had one class for every garment, and we had eight garments. So the SVM would return the class corresponding to the garment, which would then map to the owner, which would determine which hamper the clothing would be placed in.
We had our database in MongoDB on the EC2 instance. The way we ordered it is that we had a database for all of our different vectors that we stored. We had a table for each clothing item. So for example, for shirt one, we had multiple trials, which were the feature vectors. So over here, we can see that we have one LRGB, and then a second LRGB, and then we had 90 of those for each one. And then we had another table, maybe pants, and then we had multiple trials for those two. And now let's go into an explanation of the app.
Hi, this is an Android app for our Smart Hamper. What our app can do is to connect to the EC2 server and communicate with the server. Every time the camera takes a picture of clothes, it will send the pictures to server through our Pi and store it in the MongoDB. At first, everyone's connection is empty, just like this. And when I press the refresh button, it will communicate with the server and download the pictures from database and the server's name, just like this. When I press the fresh button, it shows Yuva's clothes, and this is Yuva's shirts too. When I click on the Yuva's collection, we can see Her shirt is already here.
For each piece of clothing, we had 90 samples. We noticed that when we kept adding more and more clothes, we had to add more and more samples to increase our accuracy. Our system ended up having a 78% accuracy rate for the 8 items of clothing we had. One major disadvantage that a system like this has is that it would take a lot of time to train. We created a system so that we take rapid fire pictures of a piece of clothing, and then it automatically went to the Google Cloud API and then sent it without us having to take one by one and sending it. One big application that we see for this is for laundromats. So they have a large amount of customers and lots of different people matched to lots of different clothing items, and they want to do it fairly quickly. So we see that being an application for our